Welcome back. So the next part of the event would be we will cover some of the achievements of Delhi government. Following which, Sanam, who is here from National Indian Alumni Association students, she'll give a talk about why she is here and so on. So. At all of these events, my task generally is to talk about the work of Delhi government. When we started the Andolan and then graduated to becoming a political party, it was very difficult for us to convince others when we did such events, because we never had any work to show. All we could give was promises. But now, after 3 years of successfully running a government in Delhi, we have loads of achievements. So if you have read the invites, the second sheet of the invite mostly covers the points and the key achievements of Delhi government. They are doing extremely well in education and healthcare from Aadmi. There are lot of other things that they're doing for farmers, for sanitation workers, opening toilets. We'll cover all of those. Primarily, we'll be looking at healthcare and education. I'll show you some clips of schools. Just to give you a rough data, Delhi government has allocated 24% of its annual budget for education. That is first in India. No other state has ever allocated hardly more than 6 or 8 or 10%. This is highest in India. For healthcare, they have allocated 12% of the annual budget. Now, we'll show you a couple of video clips which will explain where all that money is going. So I've made a small video showcasing all these schools. They have built 10,000 classrooms in 2 years now, and they are aiming for 20,000 by the end of 2018. Some of those classrooms, if you see in the video, they are at par with what we have here in UK. They have auditoriums, they have basketball grounds, the classrooms has new fiber benches. If you can play the first video. some of the schools have, one actually, it has got hockey as the ground now. Another school, say if you've seen any government school in India, the buildings are generally small, but the overall campus that they have is pretty huge. So in one of the schools, they came up with the AstroTurf hockey stadium. In one of the schools, they have come with athletic track. Almost the first or second slide in the video was showing that, and they are coming up with many more. I think 4 schools already have swimming pools now. Recently, there was a news where there was a Delhi state level swimming competition being held in a government school swimming pool. So that was really nice. The next video we have is, it is a promotional video shot in one of the schools where kids are showing all the facilities of their school and their classroom. If you can play the video. this was of course a promotional video, but if you go on YouTube and if you search Delhi education or Delhi schools, you'll see many, many more videos where parents and students have gone to their schools and they're showing you raw video. If someone doesn't want to believe on a promotional video. The next thing to talk about is healthcare. Delhi has done really good work on improving its healthcare system. Like we have NHS here, which is our primary healthcare center. And then you have the hospitals. So the healthcare infrastructure for UK is two-tier, whereas in Delhi they have three-tier healthcare system now. So the primary level is your Mohalla clinics. They have planned thousand Mohalla clinics. They have not been able to open all now, but 160 are fully operational. Even today, one in Saurabh Bharadwaj's constituency got inaugurated today, one, so that's in news. So they're planning to have thousands of those. These Mohalla clinics are like your GPs. They do your primary health checkup. They have a physician there who will take care of your basic healthcare needs. The next level is polyclinics. If you need a specialist, then you get referred to polyclinics. They already have 16. I think they have planned for 100 and something. There are 16 operational now. The third is hospital. So should you ever need to get admitted, only then you need to go to a hospital. Otherwise, your Mohalla clinic, which is within 1 mile, which is within almost at 1 mile or 1 or 2 kilometers distance. So that is your primary healthcare system. We'll show one video and then continue later.
पूरे देश में ये पहली बार हो रहा है. दिल्ली सरकार के सरकारी अस्पतालों में सभी दवाइयाँ मुफ्त मिल रही हैं, चाहे कितनी भी महंगी दवाई क्यों ना हो. आज तक कभी ऐसा नहीं हुआ था.
अभी हमने दिल्ली के सभी अस्पतालों में डिस्पेंसरियों में फ्री दवाइयाँ 1 फरवरी से देने स्टार्ट की हैं.
करंटली मेडिसिन आर अवेलेबल इन हॉस्पिटल. पेशेंट्स तो खुश हैं, उनको फ्री में दवाई मिल रही है हॉस्पिटल में आजकल, तो वैसे उनको कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है.
पहले क्या होता था कि सारे
पहले जब आप सरकारी हॉस्पिटल में जाते थे ना, 10 दवाइयाँ अगर डॉक्टर लिखता था एक मिलती थी, बाकी कहते थे मैं बाहर से ले लेना. अब हमने ये इंश्योर किया है, सारे डॉक्टर्स को कहा है कि जितनी दवाइयाँ डॉक्टर लिखें वो सारी दवाइयाँ अस्पताल में मिलनी चाहिए. एक भी ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि कोई दवाई अस्पताल में ना मिले.
हमारे अस्पतालों में ब्लड टेस्ट सारे मुफ्त किए जा रहे हैं.
सर पहले पैसे लगते थे ब्लड टेस्ट कराने के, हर टेस्ट के अब फ्री में होता है और सुविधाजनक होता है.
के लिए हमने हॉस्पिटल के अंदर उसको सेग्रीगेट करने के लिए सीधा उपलब्ध कराई है.
वेल मेंटेन कहते हैं स्टेट ऑफ आर्ट ब्लड बैंक है. अभी जो प्लेटलेट्स हैं उनका स्टोरेज भी है, उसको हम आईसीटर के अंदर स्टोर करते हैं. और ये मैं बताना चाहूँगा कि ये हमारा हॉस्पिटल को ही नहीं बल्कि डेंगू जैसे सीजन होता है उस समय हम प्लेटलेट्स पूरे दिल्ली को फ्री देते हैं. और अभी सब कुछ यहाँ पे फ्री है, इंक्लूडिंग ब्लड टेस्टिंग, सीटी, एमआरआई, अल्ट्रासाउंड and x-rays, all the tests and including all the medicines are given free to the patient.
ये कैसे हुआ, इतना पैसा कहाँ से आया सरकार के पास? हमने हर दिल्ली सरकार के काम में करप्शन बंद कर दिया. जैसे 125 करोड़ का फ्लाईओवर था, हमने 200 करोड़ का बना दिया. एक इंडस्ट्रियल ट्रेनिंग इंस्टीट्यूट 24 करोड़ का बना था, हमने 16 करोड़ का बना दिया. तो ये इतना सारा पैसा हम बचा रहे हैं दूसरे कामों में, उससे हम लोगों ने ये दवाइयाँ मुफ्त कर दी हैं और इससे गरीबों को, मिडिल क्लास के लोगों को बहुत फायदा हो रहा है.
अभी हमने मोहल्ला क्लिनिक खोलने स्टार्ट किए हैं. 100 के करीब मोहल्ला क्लिनिक हम खोल चुके हैं. वहाँ पर भी सभी लोगों को कंसल्टेशन फ्री दी जा रही है, टेस्ट भी फ्री कर रहे हैं, दवाइयाँ भी मुफ्त मिल रही है. दिल्ली सरकार ने 3-tier सिस्टम बनाया है. पहले लेवल पर मोहल्ला क्लिनिक होंगे, उसके बाद पॉली क्लिनिक्स खोल रहे हैं. तो दिल्ली के अंदर ऐसे लगभग 23 पॉली क्लिनिक ऑलरेडी खुल चुके हैं. और पॉलीक्लिनिक्स में भी अगर आदमी आपको एडमिट होने की जरूरत पड़ रही है तो आप अस्पताल को ले जा रहे हैं. अभी जितने अस्पताल हमारे पास है उनको सबको बेड की स्ट्रेंथ भी बढ़ा रहे हैं। अभी दिल्ली में 10,000 बेड है, उनको आने वाले 2 साल के अंदर हम 20,000 बेड करके दिखाएंगे।
बढ़िया से बढ़िया तकनीक सरकारी अस्पतालों के अंदर लेके आ रहे हैं, आने वाले 2 साल के अंदर आप देखेंगे कि दिल्ली सरकार के सरकारी अस्पताल प्राइवेट से भी ज़्यादा बेहतर हम लोग करेंगे और स्वास्थ्य के क्षेत्र में दिल्ली पूरे देश को एक विशेष है।
There is something which is missing from the video because it was made an year back. एक साल पहले ये वीडियो बना था, एक साल छह महीने पहले। अभी दिल्ली में 30-day पॉलिसी आई है, अगर सरकारी अस्पताल आपका इलाज या आपका टेस्ट या आपकी सर्जरी 30 दिन के अंदर नहीं कर सकते तो आप हॉस्पिटल से ऑटोमेटिकली 160 अप्रूव्ड प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल में रेफर हो जाते हो। तो जब इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर पे अभी इन्वेस्ट कर रहे हैं और बनने में टाइम लग रहा है, इन द मीनवाइल हमें एक सपोर्ट चाहिए, तो उसके लिए प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल से कोलैबोरेशन हुआ है। विद इन 30 डेज पीपल आर गेटिंग देयर कैंसर टेस्ट, पीपल पीटी स्कैन्स, पीपल आर गेटिंग सर्जरीज, एनी सर्जरी, और कोई भी इनकम लिमिट नहीं है आपको।
प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल फ्री,
इट्स फ्री, यस, यू गेट रेफर्ड एंड इट्स फ्री, या दैट वाज द मेन पॉइंट, इट इज फ्री। सो अब इवेंचुअली इसका फर्क क्या पड़ा कि अभी दिल्ली में आपको हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस, एक्सीडेंटल इंश्योरेंस, इस सब की जरूरत ही नहीं है। यू कैन टोटली ट्रस्ट ऑन गवर्नमेंट। जैसे यहां पे हमें सोचने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती है कि कल को एक्सीडेंट हुआ तो क्या होगा, ऐसे ही दिल्ली में है। एक्सीडेंट के लिए खास करके पॉलिसी है कि कहीं भी एक्सीडेंट होता है तो नियरेस्ट किसी भी हॉस्पिटल में ले जाओ, एंटायर ट्रीटमेंट इज फ्री, which is a very big step in terms of healthcare. और भी बहुत से टॉपिक्स हैं, अगर एंड में टाइम बचा तो भी I'll show you some of the video। जैसे हाउसिंग में बहुत लोग को
40 services free,
yes,
on the door,
yes, that is one of the most recent things which has come now। काफी government services, जैसे यहाँ पे आप driving license apply करने के लिए एक form भर दिया और आपके घर learner's license आ जाता है, ऐसे 40 services ऑनलाइन कर दिए हैं। एंड देयर आर एजेंट्स, आप गवर्नमेंट की साइट पे फॉर्म भरोगे, आपके घर एजेंट आएगा, आपका स्कैन लेगा, जो भी डॉक्यूमेंट लेना है लेगा, और आपका फाइनल डॉक्यूमेंट सीधा आपके घर आ जाएगा, तो आपको कहीं भी ऑफिस दौड़ने की जरूरत नहीं है। हाउसिंग में बहुत अच्छा काम हुआ है, बहुत सारे क्लोज टू 6,000 और 8,000 घर गरीबों को बांटे जा चुके हैं। ये एक लंबा प्रोजेक्ट है, अभी कंस्ट्रक्शन चल रहा है, तो इसलिए बहुत बड़ा डेटा हमारे पास अभी उसका इमीडिएटली नहीं है। सैनिटेशन में बहुत काम हुआ है, क्लोज टू 10,000 टॉयलेट सीट्स हैव बीन एडेड इन लास्ट 2 इयर्स। उसके हमारे पास वीडियोस हैं, पर आप YouTube पे जाके सर्च करिए, बहुत ही अच्छी फैसिलिटीज, साफ सुथरी फैसिलिटीज बना के रही है। तो दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट के काम का ऐसे तो बहुत है, उतना टाइम नहीं है सारा कवर करने का। फार्मर्स कॉम्पेंसेशन 50,000 पर हेक्टेयर, इंडिया में आज तक का हाईएस्ट कॉम्पेंसेशन है। अगर क्रॉप 60-70% से ज्यादा डैमेज है तो दिल्ली में 2 साल पहले बारिश की वजह से फसल खराब हुई थी, 50,000 पर हेक्टेयर कॉम्पेंसेशन दिया गया था। और कोई टॉपिक किसी को याद आ रहा
है?
I will invite Sanam, who is here, and she'll talk about what made her visit the event and the organization she belongs to. Sanam.
Organization called National Indian Students and Alumni Union UK. Just like Aam Aadmi Party is celebrating 5 years, we are also celebrating 5 years in the UK. We are the pan-national body that represents Indian students who come over from India, but also British Indian students who are born and brought up here. And on a national level, on an international level, we represent them. The My reason for coming today was because we find that increasingly youth is going further and further away from politics. Students, you know, politics has, in Asian mindsets, in Indian mindsets, unfortunately, politics is a bit of a dirty term. And getting involved in politics, though, as a career is a big no-no for most people. However, that doesn't mean, I mean, getting involved in politics doesn't mean that you have to go and run for a seat. It means being an active participant in the political happenings in your country. And unfortunately, even on that level, we have been moving, we've seen a trend further and further away. And on top of that, ek daag laga diya jata hai ki bhai ye to country se bahar chala gaya padhne, ye to, he doesn't care about the country, or they have left for greener pastures, they don't care about India, which is absolute nonsense. So some people don't, wo to andar rahe ke bhi they don't care then. So it doesn't make a difference. So my reason for getting involved is to make sure that Indian students who come here, interestingly, they can vote in politics here. As Commonwealth students, Indian students, even though they're here for a year, they can vote in politics. So we even run campaigns to encourage them to vote in politics here. So then to dharam banta hai ki ghar jaake to vote karo dhang se. And you should be involved and you should know what you're voting for. Ye nahi ki mujhe ek famous face pasand aa gaya and I fell for a certain marketing campaign, isliye maine vote kar diya. So I am here so I can understand what Aam Aadmi Party is doing. I've been following Aam Aadmi Party for a very long time. In fact, after India Against Corruption 2013, I think we were the first ones to bring Aam Aadmi Party over to the UK, to London School of Economics. Then Mr. Prashant Bhushan was involved. We hosted Mr. Bhushan there. We had a wonderful session. And wahan pe, so our involvement with Aam Aadmi Party started there. Subsequently, we have, you know, passively, actively been involved with translating what is happening in Delhi. And that is very important. So, I might be a bit controversial here, but I think it's a safe forum and I can be controversial, which is to say that we have to get a balance right. There's a very famous saying, ki ek Sant Guru type person was going, hundreds and hundreds of years ago, ek Sant Guru was going across a farmer's fields and the farmer was in a lot of distress because there was no us time pe borewells nahi hoti thi, pani nahi aa raha tha, to you know he couldn't irrigate his fields properly. So the farmer was in a lot of distress and this Mahan Sant Guruji was going across and to unse this farmer asked for help ke bhai, can you give me some advice, what should I do? So the Guruji said ke pani, he goes to mere paas mere ko koi pani nahi mil raha. There is no water around for me to bring to my fields. So the Guruji said ke bhai tu dig kar, tereko pani mil jayega, but dig deep. And ye bolke he went along jahan pe bhi unko pravachan dene jana tha. So he went along and this guy, this poor farmer, he starts digging. He digs a lot, nahi mila pani. And he goes ke nahi nahi nahi, Guruji bolke gaye ki dig to karna hai, to dig to main karunga. So he goes थोड़ा अपने फील्ड में थोड़ा और आगे जाके ही डग, नहीं मिला पानी, काफी डिग किया नहीं मिला पानी, थोड़ा और आगे जाके डिग किया, ऐसे ऐसे करके ही एंडेड अप अपने फार्मर भाइयों को बुला के बहुत सारे डिग्स कर लिए उसमें, बहुत सारे पॉट होल्स डिग हो गए उसकी फील्ड में एंड इवेंचुअली हिज फील्ड्स गॉट डिस्ट्रॉयड बट ही कुडंट फाइंड वाटर. अच्छा कुछ महीने बीत गए इस पूरे उसमें, तो जो संत गुरु जी इज नाउ कमिंग बैक फ्रॉम हैविंग गिवन हिज लेक्चर्स एंड हिज प्रवचंस. And उन्होंने तो जब तक वो वापस आए संत गुरु जी तो ये चारे फार्मर्स उनके ऊपर मिलकर चढ़ गए कि सर आपने तो बोला था कि पानी मिलेगा, पानी तो मिला नहीं. तो संत गुरु जी सेड यू वेट, मैंने बोला था डिग डीप, डिग वंस बट डिग डीप. एंड दैट इज माई मैसेज टू आम आदमी पार्टी फ्रॉम एन ऑब्जर्वर हु हैज बीन इन्वॉल्वड, फ्रॉम समवन हु केयर्स वेरी डीपली अबाउट इंडिया, about Delhi, which is where I was born. I'm a very proud Delhiite. And from an ardent fan of Arvind Kejriwal, is we have to get the balance right. We have to go national. Gujarat, Punjab, Rajasthan. But Delhi, which is given Aam Aadmi Party voted, is because Delhi ko koi pagal nahi bana sakta. The Delhi voter has shown time and time again, no one can make a fool out of him or her. 67 seats Aam Aadmi Party got. We can't afford to lose a single one. The only way is up. So we have to get this balance right. So we don't dig a little bit and not enough. Pani milna zaruri hai. And when I saw this pamphlet, I was super happy because that is what Aam Aadmi Party has been doing. I don't see caste written on it anywhere. I don't see cows written on it anywhere. I don't see religion written on it anywhere. I don't see, any sort of vote bank politics written on it anywhere. What I see is education. What I see is infrastructure. What I see is healthcare. And that we have to keep focusing on, because that is the only way Delhi will elect us again when the time comes. You know, Delhi will elect Aam Aadmi Party again, because that is what matters. In the UK, can anyone tell me what are the jab bhi elections hote hain, what are the three or four issues that come up?
Housing,
yes.
Hospitals,
yeah. Healthcare, yeah.
Transport.
Immigration. And university fees, education. So, gin chun ke wahi issues hai, NHS, education, infrastructure, usme housing, travel, and everything comes under that. And that is exactly what this is. And that is the mark of a successful democracy. So, our message to Aam Aadmi Party and to anyone in the country is to vote for the right party on the basis of the right messages and the right actions. Indian students, when they come here, often they do get disenchanted because everyone, you know, the belief is everyone is the same. Why is that belief there? Because if I am sitting 5,000 miles, 7,000 miles away from the country, my connect with the country is through what I see on my phone. Yeah? On my WhatsApp, on my social media, on everything. Abhi peeche we heard this huge thing of ke Aam Aadmi Party had 7,000 crores or something jo environment ke liye jo nahi use hua. There was a lot of negative 700 crores jo ki environment ke liye tha but nahi use hua. When I spoke to one of your colleagues earlier today, she explained to me the detail behind it. कि क्यों वो यूज नहीं हुआ या वो था ही नहीं कि वो दबा हुआ था कि एक्चुअली पैसा था ही नहीं जो भी है द एक्चुअल ट्रूथ बिहाइंड इट बट नो वन सीज दैट नो वन केयर्स अबाउट इट बिकॉज वो मैसेज पहुंचता ही नहीं है बाहर मैसेज सिर्फ इतना पहुंचा कि आम आदमी पार्टी के पास पैसे थे उन्होंने पैसे नहीं लिए हम तो मर रहे हैं पोल्यूशन में व्हाट इज द फेलियर हियर
कम्युनिकेशन
राइट कम्युनिकेशन इज द फेलियर किसका फेलियर है मेरा फेलियर एज द रेसिपिएंट ऑफ द मैसेज क्या आपका फेलियर एज द गिवर ऑफ द मैसेज
एग्री विद यू बट इट्स नॉट एंटायरली बिकॉज़ द अपोजिशन आर वी दे आर वेरी प्रोफेशनल बट वी आर वॉलंटरी लाइक यू नो डूइंग
100%
लेट अस टेक अ पॉइंट एज आई वुड से नहीं नहीं डिस्कशन या नो आई थिंक दैट्स व्हाट आई फील बिकॉज़ कई बार मैंने भी दिल्ली में बोला स्कूल या कॉलेज के बच्चे जो शौकिया तौर पे फेसबुक उस पर लगे रहते हैं तो व्हाई डोंट वी यूज देम वी कैन पे देम लाइक 7-8 हज़ार 10 हज़ार महीने का तो बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली वो थोड़ा मैकेनिज्म में थोड़ा सा वो आ रहा है आपको पता है कि हर एक एक्शन जो दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट का होता है उसमें स्क्रूटनी होती है सीधा तो वो बहुत सारी इसमें टेक्निकलिटीज हैं बट इन जनरल वी आर अनेबल टू ग्रो अवर आर्मी प्रोफेशनल आर्मी अब आपके हमारे ऐसे लोग हैं जो हम हैं मैं ऑफिस में बिजी हूँ दिन भर तो नहीं मिला टाइम को शेयर करने का शाम को करा लेकिन तब तक
ओपोजिशन आपकी बात बिल्कुल ठीक है देखिए आई एम इन द सेम पोजीशन ऑन अ पर्सनल लेवल आई वर्क इन इन्वेस्टमेंट बैंकिंग तो घंटों का तो कुछ होता ही नहीं स्टार्टेड सम साइड ऑन नोस यू स्टार्टेड अ रिडिकुलस टाइम इन द मॉर्निंग यू फिनिश एट अ रिडिकुलस टाइम इन द मॉर्निंग उसके साथ आई रन अ चैरिटी which is a national charity. Annual leave से जिस तरह से आप लोग annual leave से time लेके काम करते हैं हम लोग भी annual leave से time लेके काम करते हैं student से कुछ करवाना ही बहुत मुश्किल होता है उन तक मैसेज पहुंचाना ही बहुत मुश्किल होता है भाई मैं उनको बोलूँ जी रात को बॉलीवुड क्लब नाइट है तो सब भाग के आ जाएंगे उसी बॉलीवुड क्लब उसी में बोलूँ नहीं आम आदमी पार्टी की मीटिंग है जाना है सब कम आएंगे एक भी आ जाए तो बहुत बड़ी बात है तो आई नो एग्जैक्टली वॉट यू आर सेइंग वॉट आई एम सेइंग इज दैट कुछ वॉलंटियर्स ही चाहिए होते हैं जस्ट लाइक दिस रूम कोई बर्मिंगम से उठ के आया है कोई रॉमफर्ड से उठ के आया है कोई लंदन से उठ के आया है ऑल वी नीड इज अ फ्यू पीपल एंड टेक्नोलॉजी इज ऑन आवर साइड सो इट इज अ बिट ऑफ आम आदमी पार्टी इट इज समथिंग आम आदमी पार्टी नीड्स टू इम्प्रूव ऑन परहैप्स फेलियर इज नॉट द राइट टर्म इट इज समथिंग वी नीड टू इम्प्रूव ऑन अ टेक्निकल फ्रंट विच इज यू डोंट नीड एन आर्मी टू डू टेक्नोलॉजी
You need a few good people. And I think Aam Aadmi Party has that resources in Delhi. Because Delhi is the same people who voted Aam Aadmi Party 67 out of 70. My plea to Aam Aadmi Party is focus on Delhi in the short to medium term as much as you are focusing on national expansion. And that balance must be kept because the founding of Aam Aadmi Party was from Delhi. And you can't take the Delhi citizen for a ride. You are not taking the Delhi citizen for a ride, but you can't let the fake message go out that the Delhi citizen has been taken for a ride. And uske liye digital media strategy is absolutely key. Abhi kuch din pehle Rahul Gandhi ki ek video bahut viral hui, bahut viral hui. Wo kehte hain Rahul Gandhi ke ek side se main aalu dalunga, aisi machine banaunga ki main aalu dalunga ek side se aur dusre side se sona niklega. Itna paisa ho jayega ki aap logo ko pata nahi chalega ki क्या करूं मैं इस पैसे का. ये वीडियो राहुल गांधी की वायरल हो गई. किसने वायरल की?
बीजेपी ने.
पोटेंशियली समवन हु डजंट वांट द राइट मैसेज टू गो आउट. आई डोंट नो वो बीजेपी है कि कौन है. वो अपना द वोटर इज इन्फॉर्म्ड इनफ टू मेक देयर ओन माइंड अप. बट वायरल हो गई वीडियो. उसके कुछ टाइम बाद कुछ लोगों ने ये वीडियो निकाली जो फुल वीडियो थी, विच वॉज राहुल गांधी बींग सार्केस्टिक अबाउट यू नो another political opponent, be that the prime minister or be that anyone else, a political opponent to Rahul Gandhi. Now, I'm not a Congress person, I'm not an Aam Aadmi Party person, I'm not a BJP person, so I'm just an Indian, so I will say what I want here, which is Rahul Gandhi's or Congress's failure was that they let that happen. The success of the political opponent was that they could make it happen. It was all about time to market. It was all about how quickly you could manipulate the message and get it out there. Jisne bhi kiya, for whatever reason they did it. Rahul Gandhi ki image, which is already a little tainted, jo ki halaki it is improving considerably now, for all the right reasons, was maligned again because of that one image. Similarly, all these amazing videos we saw abhi, they are not viral.
Because they don't have corporate money to spread the message.
But
because
they have,
we already have that, and they are using that in an appropriate manner. Whatever they want, they are doing it with the
absolutely,
corporate money.
Absolutely. But as volunteers, it is our job to go crazy on this. Jo cheez paise, the thing is, I don't believe that when Delhi won 67 out of 70 seats, there was any corporate money involved.
Absolutely.
There wasn't.
There was.
There is a. It was the heart of the Delhi people who could see through the bullshit.
Absolutely.
Who are educated, who can't be taken for a ride, and who could see the good work. So 49 days mein good work kar diya, that is why Delhi voted Aam Aadmi Party again.
That's
right. So my point is that corporate money can only take you so far.
Yes.
Indian people aren't stupid. We might be illiterate on a mass scale. We may have a long way to go, but beyond the point, I will not care कि मैं कौन सी caste का हूँ या मैं कौन सी religion का हूँ if I don't have food to feed myself, which is the problem in our country. So I was amazed to hear that 300 people from the UK went to campaign in elections. That is an astounding figure, and I must congratulate Aam Aadmi Party UK for that. But I also wish that we take the messages of the Aam Aadmi Party out, and I will say of all the other parties as well, because that is the only way a democracy can function, to the farthest corners in the UK at least, and we come up with innovative ways of how we can help Delhi improve even more. We saw last year we hosted Manish Sisodia ji at the London School of Economics, and we had some amazing discussions with him around education. And how we can support from the UK front, because there is a lot of innovative stuff we can do. We had some very fruitful discussions. Unfortunately, they didn't lead to something else because other factors come into the way that are arguably more important. We would like to take this opportunity to say again, we are standing here willing to work with Delhi on education. There are amazing things that are happening in the UK on healthcare. There are specific courses in the UK on healthcare policy management, on how and scientific technological policy making, that people from India, leaders are chosen from India to come to the UK on. all Indian students who are already studying that here, Delhi government can take these students and put them in the right positions where they can actually make much more influence and make things happen. Because Aam Aadmi Party and Delhi government and Mr. Kejriwal, salute to them. They are, this is a government which is making things happen without the bureaucracy, without the time wastage, without the nonsense and bullshit around it. So, yahan se, US se, even in Australia, there are really, really good educational, applied educational things that learnings and knowledge and experiences that Indian students or people who have recently graduated have. Which if you put them in the right place and arm them with the right power in the government or in public-private enterprise, which only in Delhi can that happen, then that would be extremely, extremely useful for Delhi. So that is another suggestion I have for how you can actually forge even stronger ties between Aam Aadmi Party UK, Aam Aadmi Party India, and the students who come here. I must tell you, can anyone take a guess how many Indian students go abroad every year to study?
1 million?
1 million?
No,
it's fine. Utne
nahi hai.
Thode se kam.
They
are a great number.
Close to lakh or like
1.5.
So there are 300,000 Indian students that go abroad every year outside from India to study. They go everywhere in the world. They come here, they go to the US, they go to Australia, Canada, New Zealand, Dubai, China, etc. And this trend will only continue. Why is that?
Lack of
Exactly, lack of infrastructure. So it is predicted, and this is happening. Every year, there is a rise of about 10% compound annual growth rate in the number of Indian students who are going abroad to study. This is a country the size of Bahamas which leaves every year. And dare I say, these are the people who have both the educational background and the financial know-how to be a very, very valuable asset to the country. One of the good things that this current Indian government, credit where it's due, has done is to take care of this, or to actually recognize this body as a community that they need to take care of. So diaspora policy is very important. I would like to ask the Aam Aadmi Party what their diaspora policy is, particularly with regards to youth. You have an intense force of very, very educated people, very, very smart people who don't need to be funded because they have good financial backing through their families or their, you know, relatively well-to-do middle classes. Mostly these are the people who go abroad. So can the Aam Aadmi Party devise a way of engaging with this diaspora young population? Because this is the future of India. This is, everyone keeps talking about how India has 65% of its population is under the age of 35, blah, 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 500 million young people. Very good. 500 million unemployed and unemployable young people, which is a demographic disaster about to happen in our country. And in 50 years to come, we're sitting on a time bomb that is waiting to explode because no one is talking about population control. Right? Ulta hum jaake bolte hain ki har Hindu aur char bachche aur paida kare just to do the competition, free fund. I don't think so. Population control can be an issue that Delhi takes very seriously. Delhi is already burgeoning. Delhi is already and because Delhi is Delhi, it gets a lot of immigration in from all the other surrounding NCR and beyond areas which are relatively less well-to-do. That is where crime comes into Delhi from as well. A lot of crime comes because we have a lot of immigration into Delhi. Can there be something done to stop the flow of uncontrolled flow of migration into Delhi? Is there something constitutionally that allows us to do so? I don't know. That is another suggestion we have for Aam Aadmi Party to consider. To control some form of migration or put more border entry checks. Put something that is not undemocratic but allows for clearer migration trends to be observed and managed so that you don't have crime. Because a lot of crime comes. Nirbhaya happened. Where were all those people coming from? Where were their origins? Unfortunately, it was our own people. At the end of the day, we are all Indian. But if you put, unfortunately, there is a big rural and urban divide. if we don't manage rural populations properly in a sustained, governed framework, it will lead to more and more crimes because there is disenfranchisement. So, I did say I might be a bit controversial in the beginning, so I think I'm being true to that. But my point is, coming back to Indian students, diaspora policy is very important for Aam Aadmi Party, I think. 300,000 is a big asset that you can use to spread the good work you're doing. 300,000 is a majority go back. When they go back, everyone has a say these days. Aajkal favorite pastime sabka ban gaya to take offense. Everyone is offended at something or the other. Why don't we channelize this favorite pastime of taking offense into doing something constructive? And if anyone can do that, it's Aam Aadmi Party. It's Arvind Kejriwal. So I would like to implore Aam Aadmi Party to think about ways in which it takes this pool of talent, also facilitates them going out. So I know that Aam Aadmi Party is probably the first party in the country who is providing collateral free education for up to 10 lakhs collateral free loans. That is an amazing step. It is unheard of in India. But those students that are benefiting from this, can they somehow be put back into the system so that they give back to society? Can we ensure that there is a framework where, say, we choose 100 people from Delhi each year to be the recipient of such collateral free loans? We send them to specific training courses abroad, which are your bachelor's, which are your master's potentially, but in courses that India doesn't have right now. Things like artificial intelligence, which is the big thing today. Things like robotic process automation. Things like the mutual fund industry, things like healthcare policy management, international relations. These are things that India has historically, and Delhi has historically, been very weak on in terms of education. But these are things that in the UK we have in abundance. There are targeted courses. Can the Delhi government, and this is to Mr. Sisodia, can you come up with a way of giving collateral free education, or facilitating this on, and choosing students who have actually demonstrated an intent to give back to society, an intent to give back to Delhi and to India, send them here and find a way that when they go back, they're put in the right places so that their learning can be appropriately channeled. Because that is how you will bring about serious change in society. And Aam Aadmi Party is hope, flame of hope, and Aam Aadmi Party represents hope. In Delhi, that hope can't die out. So, yes, we have Rajasthan, yes, we have Gujarat, yes, we have Punjab. I'm repeating it again, we have to get the balance right, which is Delhi is where Aam Aadmi Party began from, and Delhi is where the educated voter is, who doesn't care about religion, caste, creed, beyond a certain level. Of course, everyone's faith is important to them, of course, religion is important to them, but not above your Maslow's hierarchy of needs, which is primary, not above that. So, we can't afford to lose those people in Delhi and beyond. And Aam Aadmi Party is a state party right now. Aam Aadmi Party also recognizes it needs to become a national party. Only then can it drive change from within in the entire country. But that balance must be achieved. And I wonder if there is ways in which we can provide thought leadership from an objective standpoint, from outside, to Aam Aadmi Party as well, because it represents democracy. Aam Aadmi Party is essential to India because democracy had almost died before ISE came about. And democracy, as India is the largest democracy and the UK is the oldest democracy in the world, we have a Venn diagram which ke beech mein we are genuinely the right people to further India's development socio-economically. And I really want to work with Aam Aadmi Party and make sure that there are ways in which we can channelize the talent that leaves India every year. They don't need to physically go back to India, but that talent can be channelized, be it an army to be created as a gentleman they appointed, or be it for technical expertise, or be it for sending money or contributing through crowdfunding, etc. There are many ways in which talent has to be channelized, and that is something we request Aam Aadmi Party to consider. I'm just going to stop there, and happy for you to bash me on any views that I have. But thank you.
was great to hear you all, Sanam. What we can do is post the event, we can try and sit together and find out ways in which her organization and us, how we can come together, be it on policy decisions, be it on reviewing some of the existing policies so we can further improve it and do a better collaboration. Next is Rupang. He is leading our Gujarat campaign, and he'll walk us through how Gujarat needs Aam Aadmi Party. Rupang.
Thank you, Jai Hind. Let's start with Bharat Mata Ki Jai. Bharat Mata Ki
Jai.
Bharat Mata Ki
Jai.
Bharat Mata Ki
Jai.
Well done. Thank you very much. Kemcho. Yes, I know everyone. I was expecting that from everyone non-Gujaratis. So, thank you very much, Sanam. And in a short, actually, I was just thinking and listening to her. And je nava aavya che je loko je party sathe etlo time thi associated nathi thaya, especially je Gujaratis aavya che first time. આ જે ડિફરન્સ છે કે બીજી બધી પાર્ટી કરતા આમ આદમી પાર્ટી કેમ ડિફરન્ટ છે એ અહીંયા તમને અત્યારે એક્ઝામ્પલ મળ્યું. સમવન લાઈક ન્યુટ્રલ પર્સન યુઝિંગ આમ આદમી પાર્ટી સ્ટેજ એન્ડ ગિવિંગ હર ઓનેસ્ટ ઓપિનિયન એન્ડ ધ થોટ્સ કે હાઉ વી કેન ઇમ્પ્રુવ વેર વી નીડ ટુ ઇમ્પ્રુવ. સો આઈ થિંક ધીસ ઇઝ વોટ વી આર ડિફરન્ટ ફ્રોમ રેસ્ટ ઓફ ધ પાર્ટી. એન્ડ આઈ કેન એશ્યોર યુ સનમ દેટ વોટ યુ હેવ સેડ ઇટ રિયલી મેક્સ સેન્સ. And it really got so much substance actually that we can take it further, we can introspect, and then we can take it to the Delhi team as well, that how we can use this, and we need these sort of people, because end of the day we are Aam Aadmi Party. So we work together for the people, but at the same time we have to keep our ears open to listen to our feedback, to listen to the work we have done, and also to get the criticized what we have done wrong and how we can improve that going forward. So, without taking much time, I will speak in Gujarati for a bit, actually, for the people who are here from Gujarat. And then I'm going to play one video, which just give you like the gist of what is the current situation in Gujarat. But that video is in Gujarati, so then I will translate it into the English or Hindi. So, jyare hu kahu ke I'm Rupang Shah from Aam Aadmi Party. તો ઘણા મારા ગુજરાતી મિત્રો મને આમ પૂછતા છે ક્વેશ્ચન કે તું ગુજરાતી થઈને આમ આદમી પાર્ટીને સપોર્ટ કરે છે. આઈ મીન સો એન્ડ ધ રીઝન વાય આઈ સપોર્ટ આમ આદમી પાર્ટી એ એટલા માટે કે હું અહીંયા 12 વર્ષથી છું લંડનમાં. એની પહેલાં મારું બરોડામાં બોર્ન એન્ડ બ્રોટ અપ બરોડામાં ગુજરાતમાં થયું છે. અને તમે જોવા જાઓ તો ગુજરાત એક પહેલેથી વર્ષોથી અંગ્રેજોના જમાનાથી એક બહુ ડેવલપ વેલ ટુ ડુ સ્ટેટ હતું. ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ આપણું જે અમદાવાદ છે દેટ વોઝ ઇન ધોઝ ડેઝ વી યુઝ ટુ બી કોલ લાઈક ધ માન્ચેસ્ટર ઓફ યુનાઇટેડ કિંગડમ. આપણે સુરત જે છે તે ટેક્સટાઇલ ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રી અને ડાયમંડ ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રી માટે ફેમસ છે. સૌરાષ્ટ્ર જે આપણું ઓઇલ પ્લસ ધ એગ્રીકલ્ચર, એ જ રીતે આપણું જે આણંદ છે દેટ ઇઝ મોર અબાઉટ ધ ટોબેકો. ઓન ટોપ ઓફ દેટ ઇન ટર્મ્સ ઓફ ધ ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રીયલ વી હેવ કેમિકલ ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રીઝ, ખાતર બનાવવા માટે ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રી છે. તો વી આર વેરી વેરી વેલ ટુ ડુ એન્ડ વી વેર વન સોર્ટ ઓફ લાઈક ધ પાવર હાઉસ ફોર ધ ગ્રોથ ઓફ ઇન્ડિયા એઝ વેલ. અને ઓબ્વિયસલી તમે કમ્પેર કરો કે આટલું સારું રીચ સ્ટેટ અને એની જ્યારે બેઝિક ફેસિલિટીઝ તમે કમ્પેર કરીએ, આપણે એજ્યુકેશન છે કે પછી હેલ્થ કેર છે કે ઇવન બેઝિક ફેસિલિટીઝ લાઈક ધ લો એન્ડ ઓર્ડર, તો પણ વી કેન સી ધ ડિફરન્સ કે આપણી ગુજરાતની જે હાલત છે એ બાકી બધા સ્ટેટ કરતાં એટલી સારી નથી. મોર ઓર લેસ ઇન ઓવરઓલ આપણે બધી જગ્યાએ પાછા પડીએ છીએ. અને એ વસ્તુ તમે અહીંયા આવ્યા ત્યારે વધારે ખ્યાલ આવે કે અહીંયા ગુજરાત આપણે એજ્યુકેશન છે ગવર્મેન્ટનું તો કેટલું સારું એજ્યુકેશન છે. એ ગવર્મેન્ટ ફંડેડ છે અને ગવર્મેન્ટ એકચ્યુઅલી સિરિયસ છે કે જે એજ્યુકેશન આપે છે એ કમ્પલ નોટ ખાલી આપવા ખાતરી આપે પણ એકચ્યુઅલી દેટ વિલ આઈ મીન પીપલ વિલ એન્કરેજ ટુ ગેટ ધ ગવર્મેન્ટ એજ્યુકેશન. એ જ રીતે હેલ્થકેર માટે છે. પણ આજે આપણે ગુજરાતમાં જઈએ તો એજ્યુકેશન ત્યાં આગળ જઈએ તો ગુજરાતમાં જે ગવર્મેન્ટ સ્કૂલ્સ છે ત્યાં ઇન્ફ્રાસ્ટ્રક્ચર જે છે એ બહુ બેઝિક છે. ટોયલેટ્સ પણ ઇવન નથી કેટલી ગવર્મેન્ટ સ્કૂલ્સમાં લેડીઝ અને જેન્ટ્સ માટે નહીં. તો ટીચર્સ ત્યાં આગળ દૂર જવું પડે છે અને ત્યાં આગળ બે ત્રણ જણા ઉભા રહે કે કોઈ આવે નહીં, એ હાલત છે ગુજરાતમાં આટલા વર્ષો પછી પણ. હું કોઈ પર્ટિક્યુલર પાર્ટી કે કોઈ પર્ટિક્યુલર લીડર માટે ઓપોઝિશન નથી કરવા આવ્યો કે ભાઈ, પણ પાછલા 70 વર્ષથી આ વાત થઈ રહી છે અને હજી કોઈ ઇમ્પ્રુવમેન્ટ નથી થયું. તો અને 80 વર્ષમાં જે દિલ્હીમાં કામ કર્યું છે, જે તમે વિડીયો જોયા કરના, એ યુ કેન સી કે હા, મારું ઇન્ડિયા, મારું ગુજરાત, મારું જે સિટી છે કે મારો જે જિલ્લો છે, એમાં પણ આ રીતનું સ્ટેટમાં એજ્યુકેશન હોવું જોઈએ, આ રીતની હેલ્થ કેર આવી જોઈએ. અને એ વસ્તુ આમ આદમી પાર્ટી છેલ્લા 80 વર્ષમાં દિલ્હીમાં હાસિલ કરી છે અને એટલા માટે કરી છે બીકોઝ દે આર વેરી સિરિયસ અબાઉટ ઇટ, દે આર જેન્યુઅલી હેવ અ નીડ ટુ ડુ ધેટ. ઇન્ડિયામાં આપણા ગુજરાતમાં એજ્યુકેશન હેલ્થ કેર તમે જોશો તો મેજોરિટી રન બાય પ્રાઇવેટ સ્કૂલ્સ અને મેજોરિટી જે પોલિટિશિયન્સ હોય છે દે આર ધ વન હુ ઇઝ એકચ્યુઅલી રનિંગ ઇટ, અને એ લોકોને કોઈ ઇન્ટરેસ્ટ નથી કે દે ઇમ્પ્રુવ ધ ગવર્મેન્ટ સ્કૂલ્સ. So, I will talk to you more about after playing that video. So, yeah, if you can just play the video.
Gujarat, Maru Gujarat, Vepar Mate Vishwavikhyat Gujarat, Vepar Yothi Olkhat Gujarat, Gandhi no Gujarat, Desh ane Duniya ne Ahimsa no Bodh Apna no Gujarat. જે ધરતી પર અહિંસાના પૂજારી ગાંધી બાપુ દ્વારા દેશની આઝાદીની ચળવળ ચલાવવામાં આવી, એ જ ધરતી પર જ્યારે તમે તમારા હક સરકાર પાસેથી માંગો તો વળતરમાં હિંસા મળે છે. ગુજરાતના વિકાસમાં જે સમાજનો અભૂતપૂર્વ ફાળો છે, તેવી ખંતિલી પ્રજા એટલે કે પાટીદાર સમાજ જ્યારે શાંતિપૂર્વક રીતે પોતાના હક્કો માંગવા નીકળે ત્યારે રાતના અંધારામાં જીએમડીસી ગ્રાઉન્ડમાં બાળકો, મહિલાઓ અને પુરુષો પર પોલીસ દ્વારા અંધાધૂંધ લાઠીચાર્જ કરવામાં આવ્યો. માહોલને શાંત કરવાના બદલે સરકારે ઠેર ઠેર લાઠીચાર્જ કરાયા, કેસ નોંધવામાં આવ્યા, કારણ વગર લોકોને જેલ ભેગા કરવામાં આવ્યા. સમગ્ર આંદોલને 14 જણાનો ભોગ લીધો અને રાજ્યની કરોડો રૂપિયાની સંપત્તિ નુકસાન થયું, જે સમાજના ઉત્થાન માટે બાબા સાહેબે આખું જીવન ખર્ચી નાખ્યું. તે દલિતોની ગુજરાતમાં શું હાલત છે? ઉનાના સમઢિયાળા ગામમાં ધોળ દિવસે પોલીસ ચોકી સામે દલિત પરિવારને કલાકો સુધી ઢોર માર મારવામાં આવ્યો, જે ઘટનાથી આખો દેશ ધ્રુજી ઉઠ્યો અને ગુજરાતમાં દલિત આંદોલનની શરૂઆત. લોકોનો ગુસ્સો ઠારવામાં પણ સરકાર નિષ્ફળ ગઈ અને ઠેર ઠેર આંદોલનો. આવના કાળના પીડિતો આજ દિન સુધી બળતરથી વંચિત છે. ગુજરાતની 60% જનતા આજે પણ ખેતી પર નિર્ભર છે. ત્યારે
સો યુ સી ટુ વિડિયોઝ, આઈ મીન સો ફાર ટુ ટોપિક્સ. The first one was the Patidar, much more talked about in a current election environment in Delhi, in Gujarat. So the Patidar is very dominated community, always been like the supporter of the ruling party in the Gujarat. And then they were so fed up with the way the system works, education, there is no job and all that stuff. So they just decided to have like the agitation and asking for the reservation. Now, I'm not going to go into the detail actually that whether the reservation is valid or not, but what I'm saying is that they were just simply peacefully doing the demonstration in Ahmedabad or in Gandhinagar actually, and then the police started to hit them up. And there are many videos on YouTube actually, if you see Patidar agitation, you will find that one of the guy actually was sleeping at home and then the police came in, took him away in the custody. They hit him all night and then the morning, next morning he died. And the irony of the whole situation is that even the police was not happy to register the FIR that why he died and not too happy to even get the investigation done. So And that is why, they, I mean, there are many stories like that. There was a society actually very quiet, and they got a CCTV camera. So you can see the police came in, and they just hitting like the cars and the scooters and the auto rickshaws and just damaging. So it's just a gundagardi basically. And that is why they are really upset, and it's really big, very big topic actually, and one of the main issues in these elections in Gujarat. The second part of that was the Dalit, obviously, which we call like the from the lower caste, and those guys got hit in front of the police station, and again, no action has been taken out so far, and that is why you have like the leaders like the Jignesh Mewani and Hardik Patel. They are just representing their own caste, their own like the opinion that why we are not happy or why we are making this demonstration. So.
आज सुधी खेती माटे पानी सस्ती बिजली के योग्य टेकाना भाव नथी आपी शकी आ भाजप सरकार
विकास ने बे कहता तुम्हें सरकार ना भाव टेकाना भाव सु हो नथाना भाव तुम्हें सु राजो खेलते खेली ना कई सने जब सीनो विकास का सु आमा विकास सीनो विकास बाकी विकास नो तो सर ने नाम अच्छ विकास बाकी विकास नहीं है
अने जो खेडूत पोताना हक मा पानी मांगवा निकले तो खेडूत ने पान ढोर मार मारे नवकांठाना विस्तारना अनेक गामों ने नर्मदानु पानी न मरता रोषे भरायेला खेडूतोए सानंद नजीक विरोध प्रदर्शन कर्यो हतो जेमा मोटी संख्या में खेडूतो जोड़ाया हता त्यारे तेमना पर दमन गुजारवामां आव्यो નોટબંધીના નામે 8 લાખ કરોડ રૂપિયાનું કૌભાંડ આચરવામાં આવ્યું જેમાં હજારો લોકોએ પોતાની નોકરીઓ ગુમાવી ધંધાઓ ઠપ થઈ ગયા
તુબે છે ગળ્યા છે હવે છે આ નંબર આ કેસ ખતમ હો ગયા
ના નામ કરી બેટા બેંક રે
ના નામ કરી બેટા તો બધી કેસ ખતમ હો ગયા એસે ગાડી નીકાળે તો કે ગાડી નીકાળ નીકાળ કે તો
કેસ ખતમ હો ગયા બેંક ભરભર કે પૈસે લીએ જા રહે બેંક ભરભર કે
અને 100 થી વધારે લોકોએ જીવ ગુમાવ્યો કોની ભૂલ થી
મર રહે એક બુડિયા મરી યહાં પે એક બુડિયા મરી યહાં પર બિચારી તો મતલબ પોતે ના યહાં પે દો લડકે લેકે ગયે લેકિન વો बची नहीं मर रही वो भूखी लगी हुई होगी तो उसे सांस ही नहीं आई अटैक हुआ पता नहीं क्या हुआ खड़े खड़े थी वो मर गई
पोताना तुगलक ही विचार ना निर्णय ना कारणे जरे आखो देश बैंकों की बाहर लाइन में उभो तो तेरे अपना देश ना बड़ा प्रधान मोदी जापान में अपनी स्थिति पर विदेश की धरती पर हंसी रहा था
500,000 की नोट्स
પ્રદર્શન કરવામાં
તેનોને જેલ ભેગી કરવામાં આવી. શું આજ છે વિકાસ? જે સરકારને મેં વોટ આપ્યો એ સરકારે મને લાખી આપી. શું આ છે મારું ગુજરાત? અત્યાચારી, ભ્રષ્ટાચારી અને અહંકારી ભાજપ સરકારના મંત્રીઓએ આપણી મહેનતના પૈસાથી પોતાના ઘર ભર્યા છે. છેલ્લા 5 વર્ષમાં અમિત શાહની મિલકત 300 ગણી વધી. અમિત શાહના દીકરા જય શાહની કંપનીનો નફો 16,000 ગણો વધ્યો. પૂર્વ મુખ્યમંત્રી આનંદીબેનની દીકરીને 422 એકરની જમીન 15 રૂપિયા પર સ્ક્વેર મીટરે અપાય, જે ચાલતા ભાવ પ્રમાણે 92% ઓછો ભાવ છે. સૌરભ પટેલે ગુજરાત સરકારમાં ઉર્જા અને પેટ્રોકેમિકલ્સ મંત્રી તરીકે 14 વર્ષ કામ કર્યું. પોતાના નામે 8 તેલના બ્લોક છે અને ભાઈ તથા ભાભીના નામે તેલની કંપનીઓમાં મોટો હિસ્સો છે. બીજેપીના વરિષ્ઠ નેતા બાબુ ભુખીરિયાએ 2006માં માઇન્સ કાંડમાં 54 કરોડનો કાંડ કર્યો. મેટ્રો રેલ તો હજુ ચાલુ નથી થઈ તે પહેલા જ સંજય ગુપ્તાએ ₹113 કરોડનું કૌભાંડ આચર્યું છે. જ્યારે સ્ટીલ કૌભાંડમાં પણ સંજય ગુપ્તાએ કરોડો રૂપિયાનું કૌભાંડ આચર્યું છે. કરોડો રૂપિયાની સરકારી હોસ્પિટલ ભારતીય જનતા પક્ષના મંત્રી શંકર ચૌધરીએ પોતાના નામે કરી લીધી. પુરુષોત્તમ સોલંકી મત્સ્ય કૌભાંડમાં 400 કરોડ ચાઉ કરી ગયા. સાહેબ તો કે છે હું ખાતોય નથી ને ખાવા દેતોય નથી, પણ સાહેબ કેગનો રિપોર્ટ કે છે ભારતીય જનતા પક્ષના મંત્રીઓ 25,000 કરોડ ખાઈ ગયા, એનું શું જવાબ માંગશો તો માર પડશે. ભારતીય જનતા પક્ષના રાજમાં ગુજરાતનું દેવું 1,82,000 કરોડને પાર કરી ગયું છે. શું આજ છે વિકાસ? છેલ્લા 3 વર્ષમાં 1500 ને છેલ્લા 10 વર્ષમાં 10,000થી વધુ ખેડૂતોએ આત્મહત્યા કરી છે. જાણો છો કેમ? કેમ કે એમને પાક માટે પાણી નથી મળતું. સરકારે નર્મદા યોજનાનો પ્રચાર તો કર્યો, પણ 70% કેનાલનું કામ આજ સુધી પૂરું થયું જ નથી. 5.5 લાખ ખેડૂતો આજ સુધી વીજળીના કનેક્શનથી વંચિત છે. ટેકાના ભાવના નામે ભારતીય જનતા પક્ષની સરકારે ધરતી પુત્રોની ક્રૂર મજાક કરી છે. 1,000 એકર ખેડૂતોની જમીનને બળજબરીથી પચાવી પાડીને ભાજપ પોતાના માનીતા ઉદ્યોગપતિઓને પથરાવી દે છે. શિક્ષણ કે સેવાનું કામ છે એને વેપાર બનાવ્યો છે ભારતીય જનતા પક્ષની સરકારે. સરકારી શાળાઓની કઠળતી હાલત અને ખાનગી શાળાઓમાં ધરખમ વધારો અને તેમાં ચાલતી લૂંટ આ છે ભાજપની દેન. રાજ્યના 4th ભાગના વિદ્યાર્થીઓ ધોરણ 10 પહેલા જ અભ્યાસ છોડી દે છે. શું આજ છે વિકાસ? 1300 શિક્ષકોની શાળાઓમાં કમી છે. 42 પ્રાથમિક શાળાઓ શિક્ષક વગર જ ચાલે છે. ધોરણ 5માં ભણતા 47% બાળકો માતૃભાષા ગુજરાતીનો એક ફકરો પણ વાંચી નથી શકતા. ભારતીયોના શિક્ષણની વાત કરીએ તો 21 રાજ્યોમાં થયેલા સર્વેમાં ગુજરાત 20મા નંબરે આવે છે. શું આ છે મારા વિકાસ? ભાજપના રાજમાં શિક્ષણની સાથે સાથે સ્વાસ્થ્ય સેવાઓ પણ કથળતી જાય છે. કેગ રિપોર્ટ પ્રમાણે માત્ર 24% સરકારી સ્વાસ્થ્ય કેન્દ્રો કાર્યરત છે. મહિલાઓ માટે કહેવાતા સુરક્ષિત ગુજરાતમાં બળાત્કાર છેડછાડના કિસ્સાઓ દિવસે ને દિવસે વધી રહ્યા છે. નડિયા સેક્સ કાંડ કે જેમાં સમગ્ર ગુજરાતના લોકો માથું શરમથી ઝૂકી ગયા.
અત્યાર પ્રચારી દેનારા નડિયા દોષી કેસના આરોપ So, from onwards, it will be all about the our government's work. So, we're just going to pause here just to save the time because we have already covered that in the earlier session. But, अगर देखा जाए तो ये है हमारे गुजरात की सच्चाई और यहाँ पे अगर गुजराती की जगह कोई भी वर्ड डाल लीजिए कर्नाटक का डाल लीजिए या पंजाबी डाल लीजिए या बंगाली डाल लीजिए द सिचुएशन इज द सेम कोई चेंजेस नहीं है फार्मर्स हैं वो आज भी मर रहे हैं पूरे देश में शिक्षक हैं वो टीचर्स हैं वो अभी भी कम है पूरे गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स में हेल्थ केयर है वो अभी भी पथेटिक है ऑल ओवर द इंडिया में और इसीलिए ये जो हमारी आम आदमी पार्टी बनी है वो मेरे और आपके जैसे लोगों से बनी है हमें किसी ने नहीं बोला है कि आप आइए आज ये इवेंट करिए इट इज ऑल अबाउट द वॉलंटियर्स वेन्यू हमने फाइंड किया है इवेंट हमने ऑर्गेनाइज किया है एक्सपेंसेस वी हैव शेयर्ड सो दिस इज व्हाट बिकॉज वी ऑल हैव अ ड्रीम टू सी द इंडिया करप्ट फ्री टू हैव द इंडिया विच प्रोवाइड्स अ क्वालिटी एजुकेशन एंड हेल्थ केयर नो मैटर विच रिलीजियस बैकग्राउंड विच रिलीजियस बिलीफ यू हैव वेदर यू आर हिंदू मुस्लिम दलित पटेल डजंट मेक एनी डिफरेंस वी ऑल आर इंडियन एट द एंड ऑफ द डे What we are getting in the UK, what we are getting in the developed world, we should all get in that in India. And that is why we are fighting. Aam Aadmi Party, agar main aapko batau, to we have one MLA who was a housewife in Delhi. Usko ticket liya hai party ne. Now, Gujarat mein election hai, aap batau, ticket ke liye kitna paisa dalna padta hai. Then only you get the ticket from the X or Y party or from the X and Y seat. To ek housewife ko ticket diya hai. Ek auto wala hai, usko ticket diya hai. There is a guy, Adar Shastri, who is a grandson of our Lal Bahadur Shastri, jo hai unke saupatr hai. Wo US mein apna job chhodke 12,000 rupees mein bhi MLA ki job kar rahe. Our MLA is only getting 12,000 rupees in India. Aur unka sab yahi hai ke we all want to change India. Aur ye hamara ek platform hai. Aur abhi agar aap dekhoge ye pura leaflet, ye leaflet mein humne aisa nahi kaha hai ki hum Gujarat mein kya karenge. इस लिफ्ट में हमने ऐसा नहीं कहा कि पंजाब में हम क्या करने वाले थे ये लिफ्ट में हमने कहा है कि पिछले 22 साल में विद लिमिटेड पावर वी हैव व्हाट वी हैव डन एंड व्हाट वी हैव अचीव एंड दैट इज रिमार्केबल हमारे पास कोई एक्सक्यूज नहीं है कि देश बड़ा है चैलेंजेस बहुत बड़ी है इतना टाइम लगता है नहीं ये 22 साल में मैं आपको चैलेंज के साथ बता सकता हूँ अगर ये आम आदमी पार्टी नहीं होती तो 22 साल के बाद दिल्ली के गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स में आज भी स्विमिंग पूल नहीं होते And that is the difference we are getting here. We are not against anyone, any particular leader or party. We are just against the corrupt, basically corrupt system. So I would suggest, जो भी हमारे लोग आए हैं यहाँ पे आज सुनने के लिए, just spread the news and just be part of this change. This is the revolution and this is the way forward. हमें अपने आप अंदर जाके system को साफ करना है और हमें एक अच्छा काम मिला कि we have the leader now. Arvind Kejriwal is the leader. Who is very honest, who has left very lucrative job, which he achieved in a very early stage of his career. वो चाहता तो farm house लेके दो तीन साल हर साल में abroad जाके अच्छा कमा लेता और अपना 2 million का रुपया लेके farm house वगैरह सब कुछ होता. But he left that job to do something for better India. So we have a leader now. All we have to do is to support him to achieve what he wants to do and to spread the work he is doing. And that's it. Very simple है. अगर कोई ज्यादा कंट्रीब्यूट करना चाहता है मोर देन हैप्पी लेकिन दैट इज व्हाट वी कैन डू एज अ मिनिमम टू चेंज अवर इंडिया तो विद दैट आई वुड लाइक टू हैंड इट ओवर टू राहुल एंड देन वी कैन जस्ट कंक्लूड द इवेंट
या सो विद दिस वी कैन क्लोज द इवेंट हैरी डू यू हैव समथिंग टू से फाइनल अवे टू पीपल Okay, take your time. Yeah, so over 3-4 years that we have been campaigning in different parts, for different parts of the country, like Rupang mentioned, the problems are same. Healthcare, education, sanitation, infrastructure, and these things lead to various other things. Abhi jaise humne patidar andolan ka dekha, Chignesh Mewani ka andolan ka dekha, aisa nahi hai ki ye bache पागल हैं और एक जाति के लिए रिजर्वेशन चाहते हैं इसलिए पागल हो गए बट एवरीथिंग अराउंड एजुकेशन खराब है हेल्थ केयर खराब है इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर खराब है ऑपरेशन हुआ है उसकी वजह से दे कम अप विद डिफरेंट एजेंडास अगर उनको जैसा दिल्ली में कुछ एग्जांपल देखा, अभी भी दिल्ली में हर कुछ नहीं हो पाया है जो पार्टी का एम है, अभी बहुत टाइम लगेगा, बहुत सारी चीजों पे काम हो रहा है, लेकिन अगर ये सब चीजें सही होती हैं तो फिर कोई क्यों आके बोलेगा कि मुझे रिजर्वेशन चाहिए? अगर किसी को हॉस्पिटल में फ्री में इलाज मिल रहा है, किसी के बच्चे को बचपन से और बड़े होने तक गवर्नमेंट उसकी एजुकेशन का देखरेख कर रही है, उसका रिटायरमेंट पोस्ट रिटायरमेंट, जैसे दिल्ली में अभी कई पॉइंट्स हम लोग कवर नहीं कर पाए, बहुत सारे सीनियर सिटीजन सेंटर्स बने हैं वेर वहां डॉक्टर्स विजिट करते हैं, दे हैव ऑल इंडोर गेम्स फैसिलिटीज, अगर ये सब सुविधा मिलेगी तो जात धर्म इस सब पे आगे जाने के लिए किसी के पास टाइम ही नहीं बचेगा। तो प्रॉब्लम्स आर सेम, वी वेर पार्ट ऑफ एन आंदोलन, हमें लगा उधर से उतना नहीं हो पा रहा है तो अब हम पॉलिटिकल पार्टी में आ गए। अभी आप लोग को कैसा फील होता है नहीं पता, पर मुझे अपने वॉलंटियर्स का पता है, जब दिल्ली की एजुकेशन डेली नए स्कूल इनॉग्रेट हो रहे हैं, डेली नए मोहल्ला क्लिनिक इनॉग्रेट हो रहे हैं, वो देख के लगता है जैसे हमने ही किया है, जबकि हम इतने दूर है यहां से, जस्ट बिकॉज वी वॉलंटियर, दैट फीलिंग ऑफ फुलफिलमेंट एंड कंप्लीटनेस की कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट कर रहे हैं पार्टी में, हो सकता है हमारी वजह से 10 लोग और जुड़ जाए, और उसकी वजह से जो दिल्ली में काम हो रहा है, जब वो स्कूल्स दिखते हैं, वो बच्चे खेलते हुए दिखते हैं, तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है। तो आप लोग से यही अपील है कि अपनी अपनी जगह पे जहां भी हैं आम आदमी पार्टी के काम दिखाइए, और कभी भी ये मत सोचिए कि सामने वाला, अगर आप आम आदमी वाला वोट पार्टी वाला है तो ही उसको समझाएंगे, किसी को भी बताते रहिए, सबको बताते रहिए, शेयर करिए। आम आदमी पार्टी का डोनेशन बहुत ट्रांसपेरेंट है, आप में से जिसको भी लगे कि आम आदमी पार्टी को आगे बढ़ाना चाहिए, डोनेट करना चाहिए, आप उनकी वेबसाइट पे जाइए और सीधा इंडिया डोनेट करिए। हम कभी कभी फैसिलिटेट करते हैं डोनेशंस लेना, बट वी प्रेफर कि आप उनकी साइट पे जाइए और वहां से डोनेशन करिए हमारे। और इधर यूके के लिए अगर किसी का मन है डोनेट करने का तो वो डोनेट कर सकता है, जैसे इवेंट करने में हमें थोड़े बहुत फंड्स की जरूरत पड़ती है तो आप डोनेट कर सकते हैं। आप अगर किसी को डोनेट करना है या उसके बारे में और इन्फॉर्मेशन चाहिए तो हैरी बैठे हुए हैं, आप उनसे पूछ सकते हैं। So I think with that, we should conclude the event. We still have time. We can hang around here and we can, talk about आगे कैसे साथ काम कर सकते हैं या किसी के भी questions हैं वो हम continue कर सकते हैं। Harry, if you can just say a few words and then.
बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया राहुल भाई। बहुत ज़्यादा लंबी चौड़ी बात नहीं करूँगा, बस जितने भी लोग यहाँ पर वॉलेंटियर्स नए बंदे अपना समय निकाल कर आए हैं उनको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ कि आपने समय निकाला। एंड स्पेशल थैंक्स टू सनम जिन्होंने अपने विचार हमारे सामने समक्ष रखे। विचार रखने से, बातचीत करने से समझ में आता है कि कई चीज़ें बेहतर की जा सकती हैं, चाहे आम आदमी पार्टी का बारे में हो, क्योंकि इवेंचुअली ऑल बॉयज डाउन टू कि हम बेहतर एक देश कैसे बना सकते हैं, प्लेटफॉर्म कोई भी हो सकता है। तो आई अप्रिशिएट योर फीडबैक जो आपने दिया सनम, एंड वी विल डेफिनेटली लुक इनटू दैट, एंड आई एम रियली होपिंग कि वी विल वर्क इन कोलैबोरेशन विद यू, एंड वी यूज टू वर्क बिफोर एज वेल, आप दोबारा उसी लाइन पे काम करेंगे। जाने से पहले एक ही अपील सबको करना चाहता हूँ कि जितने भी आज नए लोग हमारे साथ जुड़े हैं, कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन छोटा या बड़ा नहीं होता है। जब हमने यहाँ से शुरू किया तो कुछ ही लोग थे, आज हमारे कुल मिला के 12 टीम्स हैं, तो धीरे धीरे एक तिनके से झाड़ू बना है यहाँ पे भी, आम आदमी पार्टी यूके का जो झाड़ू है। तो कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन किसी भी तरीके से कर सकते हैं, यहाँ पे तन मन या धन से, इट्स ऑल अबाउट पॉजिटिव एंड पॉजिटिविटी। पॉजिटिविटी विल टेक यू सो लॉन्ग, नेगेटिविटी थोड़े समय तक आवाज निकालती है लेकिन बाद में वो चुप हो जाती है। तो सबको मैं यही कहना चाहूँगा कि पॉजिटिव रहिए, आम आदमी पार्टी जो काम कर रही है उसका मैसेज, जैसे राहुल ने बोला, कि आगे पहुँचाइए। यहाँ से आप इंडिया में डंडा खाने के अलावा हर काम कर सकते हैं। टेक्नोलॉजी आज इतनी ज़्यादा एडवांस हो चुकी है, जैसे सर ने पहले बताया भी कि हमारा जो पॉजिटिव मैसेज है वो शायद हम वॉलंटियर्स में ही नहीं, इंडिया की जो और दिल्ली में, पंजाब में और पूरे हिंदुस्तान में जो लोग बैठे हैं उन तक नहीं पहुंच पा रहा है, शायद अगर वो पहुंचे तो हमारी रीच और ज़्यादा बढ़ सकती है। तो तन मन और धन से आम आदमी पार्टी यूके और आम आदमी पार्टी इंडिया का सपोर्ट कीजिए। हम सिर्फ आपसे यही उम्मीद करते हैं कि आप जितना भी समय निकाल सकते हैं या एरिया में जाके कुछ कैंपेन करना चाहते हैं, आप हमारे साथ जुड़िए। हमारी डिफरेंट डिफरेंट टीम्स हैं, चाहे आप एक घंटा निकाल सकते हैं, चाहे पाउंड दे सकते हैं, या आप इंडिया में जाके कैंपेन का हिस्सा बनना चाहते हैं, जिस तरह से भी आप हिस्सा बनना चाहते हैं आम आदमी पार्टी का, हम उसको मेक श्योर करेंगे कि आपका जो समय है वो सही दिशा में और एक पॉजिटिव दिशा में वो हम यूज कर सके। इतना ही कहता हुआ इंकलाब के नारे से इस इवेंट का समापन करते हैं। इंकलाब,
इंकलाब।